So it has been pretty much 2 years since we began blogging, video blogging, YouTubing about the Legos, about the blocks. So as a second anniversary celebration type thing, I thought I would just have a bit of a squizzy at all the boxes that I have collected throughout those years. So basically, a lot of people collect Lego, but I'm more about the boxes because I recognize that a lot of the money that you pay for in Lego is actually from the boxes. So anyway, I've got a few in here, and then we can go out to the shed and have a look at my stash. So I hope you enjoy it. Thank you. So we'll start out with a damn classic that I only got about a month ago or so. And I don't know if I even need to mention what it is, but it is Lion's Knight's Castle. And I've built about two-thirds of that, maybe three-quarters, and I'm going to get back to that at some point soon, but part of it's been used in a mock I did, and I'm thinking of turning it into a medieval McDonald's, because I got those McDonald's play sets last night, so kind of thinking of doing a mock like that. So there it is, that's that box, okie dokie. Now this, I believe, is my latest Lego acquisition, the Viking Village. Obviously haven't built it yet, but I will certainly get onto it in the semi-near future, I think. So this looks like a really cool set. I've heard it's pretty basic, not basic obviously, but not so challenging as some things. But at 2100 pieces, that's a nice count, and it should keep me going fairly decently. And let's just have a look. Oh, that's just the same. Okay, and I, of course, as usual, I got this at a pretty decent price. So there you go, another 18 plus of the Viking Village. Now for a couple of speed champions. We got the Too Fast, Too Furious, Nissan Skyline, and the Ferrari Competizione 812. It's pretty funny, this is such a beautiful car, but it's flooded the market at the moment. I was at my secondhand Lego shop in Melbourne, and there was like three or four of them on display, just because, yeah, there's so many of them on the market. But everyone's talking about this Nissan Skyline as being a classic, for the future, but it'll probably be on the market for a while anyway. But yeah, these were both really fun builds, and I've got to say Speed Champions definitely is one of my favorite lines, just because the build experience is so much fun. It's quite technical, it's always not challenging, but very visceral, and kind of it gets your mind working, because they are solid vehicles. It's not like a city car at all, you know. So yeah, those are my two speed champions of the moment. Dum-bidi-dum-bidi-dum. Now for another mega set, over 6,000 pieces, just bought recently. One of my first purchase from the Lego store online, just because that was the only place you could get it. Of course, it's an exclusive, I believe. And of course, it is the City Markets of Ninjago. Now I've built two-thirds of this so far, and I'm getting into the third book kind of now, but at the moment I'm not really feeling that kind of Lego build vibe, so I'm just kind of sitting on it for the meantime. And well, yes, this is quite a set, as you can tell. It's really quite brilliant, and because I'm such a piece queen, trying to get as many pieces for as little money, this was my choice over Rivendell. Don't know if I'm ever going to get Rivendell, to be honest. Probably. But this has been a really fun build, to be honest. So yeah, City Gardens, City Markets. And talking about City Gardens, of course it is Ninjago City Gardens. What a set. Just pure Lego perfection, this one. So many minifigs, such a brilliant, beautiful, lovely, interesting, funny, silly build. It was so damn good. It really was one of the best things I've ever done. And it took me about, to be funny, I kind of did it in blibs and blobs, and this level here kind of fell apart, which forced me to stop building for a while. I mean, yeah, I was kind of out of it and kind of lovesick and things and kind of put off building for a while, but I finally did it and it looks magnificent and it looks even better from the back. So there you do go. This side, like that, really is wonderful. So that was Ninjago City Gardens. Boom! Yeah, yeah, yeah. One of the best. Definitely one of the best. And now, a little bit of non-Lego recent purchases that I've got. Let's have a look at this one. It is Taekwon 5, which was a manga, a Korean manga for anime from the 70s and 80s. I think it's still going. And this is from a brand called Oxford Blocks, which is Korean and arguably as good quality, if not better, than Legos. So I haven't built this yet. I pieced out the feet and stuff and I'm not quite sure where they are, but they'll turn up somewhere. And this top build looks like so much fun. It's actually, the motif is white, is red, black, blue, and yellow. So that'll be really cool to build whenever I get around to it, Brick for Mania, and just have a look around the back. This is what the character looked like in the series. And sadly, no minifigs with this one, but they're the crew of the TV show. And there's a little plaque that you get with it. So there you go. That is Taekwon 5 by Oxford Bricks. And going on to another Oxford Bricks set, let's have a look at this one. Yes, it's Doraemon with his house, Nobita House. So this is a lovely build. This one, I haven't done it yet, but it looks so much fun. Doraemon! Doraemon! He's around somewhere, but there you go, lovely minifigs with this one. And it looks like such a tender, tender, lovely build. So, yeah. Doraemon! Baby! So this is what the build looks like. It's fully modular, I think. So you see these levels here all going on. And it's broken up into three builds. And I thought there's three bags in the box, but they're all mixed up and jumbled and stuff, so yeah, I'll have to get into it at some point. As I say, not really feeling in the building mood right now. I prefer to do some videos, but I guess that's kind of how it goes. So there you go. Doraemon! Ah, and there's a gold seal. Nice. So that's that. And talking about lovely, pretty, interesting sets, let's go into a bit of Friends, shall we? Now this set was a bit, not really a mission to get, but I heard it was one of the best sets overall from last year of all Legos. It's this one. The community building, the community center. And yeah, it looks wonderful. And four stories plus the fifth, which I'm gonna show you in a minute. And yeah, pink, yellow, green, and blue. Six minifigs. It looks really good. Have a look around the back. Around the side. This is cool. I only got this last week, so haven't really had a great look at it. But, definitely gonna get around to building this at some point soon. And thinking, yeah, possibly using these bricks to do a mock of the bookshop. So that'll be cool. And yeah, that's a pretty cool set. Is there anything on the other side? No, no. So this would be such a cool playset. I'm really looking forward to this one whenever I get around to it. So, but talking about that, let's have a look at the add-on for it. Yes, we got Miss Abuelita in the community kitchen. So as I say, it was pretty interesting that they did this so that you could just buy the kitchen, but then buy the big set as an add-on and it all builds into a community center and things. Who's this? Ah, it's Casbah. Hey, doll. So this cost me a little bit. I mean, I got it under retail, obviously. So, oh God, it's got a kitty. Got a friend for you, Casbah. Little kitty. So that's cool. And as you can see, the interior of this looks quite nice. All of those things. And yeah, as you see, they add together. to build a 5-story skyscraper. Is 5 stories a skyscraper? I don't know, high-rise living, but we'll certainly get around and see what that's like in the long run. Okay, I think that's all we've got. Oh no, we've got one more, friends. So let's see who that friend is. Actually, I've got 2 friend sets left to show you, but here's this one. And what a set this build was. It is this one. The theme park type thing. I forget what it's called, the beach theme park, something like that. Fun park. Haven't completed this. I've done about 4/5. I've just got this build to do. So that should be a highlight. But the way this all runs on Technics is really, really fun. Nice, solid build. Definitely worth getting. And it's still on the market. It's still out there. I did think this wasn't a great seller, but definitely worth having a look at. Let's have a look at the back. Oop. Uh-huh. Arrgh. There we go. Yes, indeed. You see all the different scenes going on there. Interesting. Da-dee-dee-dee. Such a cool set. So much fun. This will be so cool to finally finish and things. So yeah, anyway, one last friend set to look at for the minute, and let's have a look at it now. And this is the one. It is the canal boat, I believe, or houseboat. Really looks like a fun build, this one. And as you see, old school friends. Interesting. I think their new line is great, but their previous line was a bit subtler, a bit more classic, not quite as modern, I guess, but definitely some great builds. And I'm looking forward to doing this one when I get a chance. There we go. It opens up and all those kinds of things. I might actually build this today. This looks like the kind of build that I'd be into for. And there's a little cat for Jasper to play with. Nice. So I think we'll be heading out into the shed now. I'll show you an acquisition I got recently, which I haven't done much on yet. But let's just have a quick look at that. And it is non-Lego. Da-da-da. So yeah, these are some nano blocks. Generic nano blocks I got at Kmart. Really cool. Come on, Jasper, you can't sit there, mate. So it's a 10 plus set, almost 2,000 pieces. I got 2 other dinosaur sets, all 2,000 pieces. It's if you know nano blocks, you know that this isn't going to be a walk in the park, you know what I'm saying? These can test you quite well. So those are the other 2 that I've got as well. That looks awesome. And these were the only 2, they had 1 set left of each in the shop, so I had to buy them, obvi. So yeah, 3 designs to collect, and I've collected them all. Nice. So this one started, and basically the first five or six steps honestly took me a couple of hours. Maybe just getting into the swing of things and stuff, but yeah, it was a bit epic. So anyway, I actually found I got a couple more in the house, so we'll do those, and I'll be out in the shed doing the ones in the shed a little bit later. Okay, so let's have a look at these ones. Yes, it's Gabby's dollhouse. I quite like these sets. They're so beautiful and fun. And there you see, we got this one there, the garden party, Kitty Fairy's garden party. And down below, we've got Gabby and Meerkat's ship and spa. So these, I've opened these up and had a look, gave a set to my neighbor's daughter, or her brother's daughter. So they're all good. Let's have a look around the back. So that's what it all looks like when it's built, which is pretty cool. This one at least. Oh, and the fairy print, the cat fairy. Nice one. Oh yes, of course, I actually did start this one. That's right. My mind's a little bit terrible at the moment, but yeah, this is nice and fun. And having a look at this one, I kind of used the boat in one of my mocks as well, but that's pretty cool. Indeedy doody. There you go, bit of Gabby's dollhouse. And in a sec, we're gonna go in the house and have a look at He-Man! Castle Grayskull. What a cool build this looks like. Indeed. So, this was imported from the UK. It was never released in Australia. It looks super, super cool. Watch some videos about the build. The manual is quite different. You really get the sense of Americana in a way looking at that. But let's just have a look inside of this one. What a picture. What a picture. That's so cool. That is so much fun. Like, yeah, heck yeah. Then this thing's on the side. There, so that's cool. And then you can see the interior. I'm actually planning at some point to do like a Clash of the Castles video between Lion's Knight's Castle and this one. So, and these aren't the only boxes. I'll just have you a quick squeeze at the other ones. And I'm not sure where I put the manual. It'll turn up somewhere. So they're the individual boxes that they come in, which is so cool. Such a good idea. Yeah. And it was funny. I guess it makes sense. When you buy it, the boy figures, the boy action dolls are built together. The female ones, you've got to put them together yourself. It's pretty funny. Yeah, I guess that's just how it goes. Life's not easy for girls. You got to do it all yourself. Anyway, that is Castle Grayskull, and I'll just show you a set that I bought yesterday. It is this one, the Macca's Makers. The brick built McDonald's. And I actually got two of these, so I'm planning to do a modular, as I said, with Lion's Knight Castle, something like that. So, definitely good. And look, I'm all for diversity and stuff, but it was an interesting thing. Like, the two minifigures, you got an African or a dark person and a Ranga, and I'm pretty sure with white children, they're always going to choose the Ranga. Anyway, diversity fail in some senses there. But I don't mind, of course, I love niggas, so it's all good. But there you go, nice one. And in a minute, I'm gonna head out into the shed. It's a bit hot today, so you won't notice it, but I'll be out there in a sec and show you the mountain of boxes. Here we go, and this is Nova Bricks. I've never heard of Nova Bricks. So, thanks, and I'll be there in a sec.
Mountains into that ocean won't make that sadness.